Mga ka-nation, today on Lasang Pinoy, we have our friend Chef Mark Sanches of Bread and Butter Clovis and Spoon and Fork Catering to teach us how to make a Visayan pudding called Bahug-Bahug.
From Bukidnon to Cebu to Leyte, paborito nila itong Bahug-Bahug, whose name can't really be translated Ginge into English or Tagalog, but we're gonna try anyway.
You know, that's what we love to do. Well, Jace, when bread starts to get stale at, you know, medyo may amoy na, they say baho-baho na siya in Bisaya. Mm-hmm. Tapos, ang bahog naman, it means to add liquid. So you add milk and a few other liquid ingredients and voila, you have baho-baho.
Ah, I like that. So stale bread plus milk plus other secret ingredients. Thank you for, I gotta give a shout out to our Cebuano editor, Joe Taok, for that story. And also, thank you to our friend Cebuano chef, Mark Sanches, who is going to make bahug-bahug for us today here on Lasang Pinoy.
Ali, maghimo tag bahug-bahug!
Hello mga ka-nation! This is Chef Mark Sanches of Bread and Butter Bakery and Spoon and Fork Catering here in Fresno, California. At our farmers markets, we have over 15 varieties of breads each time. There is one particular bread na siguro 2 to 3 weeks ko lang ginagawa in a year. It's because our main ingredients are our leftover breads that makes that bread very delicious. So, alam niyo na ba ang tinutukoy ko? In Cebu, we call it bahug-bahug. In some other provinces, they call it pudding. So mga ka-nation, ano ang tawag sa tinapay na to sa lugar ninyo? So, let's do it. Let's make it. Let's go! Magsugod na ta! There are two processes on making this bread. We have our pudding process and we have our dough process. First, we'll do our pudding process. And our ingredients are leftover breads, one egg, one can of evaporated milk, one can of condensed milk, 2 tablespoons of vanilla, and drops of red food coloring. For our dough process, our ingredients are 4 cups of all-purpose flour, 1 cup of oil, 1.5 cups of water, 1/4 cup of sugar, 1 gram of salt, 1/2 teaspoon of yeast, and 1 egg. So let's make our pudding mixture. So break 1 egg in a bowl, then add your condensed milk, followed with the evaporated milk, the vanilla. Mix it all together until all is combined. So add a few drops of red food coloring. Add more if it's too light and set aside. And now we are going to break the breads into small pieces. Then we will add our pudding mixture. So make sure that the mixture is not too wet. If the mixture is too wet, we can add more bread. If it's too dry, we can add more mixture. So if you can see, ito dapat ang consistency natin. So for our dough, we will mix the wet ingredients first. Water, our oil, our egg, sugar, salt, yeast, then flour. So ngayon, let's start mixing. So check your dough for gluten development. When you see this one, when you stretch the dough, when you see a thin film and you can see your finger through it, that means your dough is fully developed. Let's give it a rest for 10 minutes. Set the oven for 350 degrees Fahrenheit. After resting the dough, what we'll do is to divide the dough into 2 parts. So, kailangan natin ng tray. We need trays or 1 tray for this bread. Spray natin para hindi didikit yung ano, dough natin. Okay? We will flat the dough
i-flatten natin. So when you get your right dimension para sa pan natin, so what we'll do is to roll the dough. Then i-position mo yung pan dito. And roll out. Yan. So now, what we are going to do is to put the pudding, the filling. Start tayo sa sides. Okay, start sa sides. I-fill natin ang pan. Press it in para walang gap. So important sa mixture natin, pantay-pantay. Para when we put the top on, yung cover natin, maganda siya tingnan. So, ang gagawin natin is to press the sides of the dough para ma-adhere yung doughs natin. We have our extra doughs here sa sides. We'll just roll it up sa rolling pin. Yan. Ito na yung bahug-bahug natin. Let's make egg wash. 1 piece of egg, 1 tablespoon water. Now, let's brush the top of the bread. And don't forget to poke holes. Use a fork. So you can just leave it like this or lagyan nyo ng sesame seeds sa ibabaw. Yan. Okay, now our bread is ready to bake. Our baking time is 30 to 45 minutes. Okay, so let's try to slice our bread even if it's still warm. Kasi masarap talaga ang tinapay na mainit. Okay mga ka-nation, so alam nyo na paano gumawa ng bahu-bahu. So next time, pag may mga lumang tinapay kayo, huwag nyo itapon. Gawa kayo ng bahu-bahu, use my recipe. You've seen it first here in Adobo Nation and next sa YouTube channel ko. So please subscribe sa YouTube channel ko. It's Musina, Mouxina. Please follow us on our Facebook and Instagram, Chef Mark Sanchez, Bread and Butter Clovis, and Spoon and Fork Catering. Till the next cooking and baking video. Bye!